In this video, I'm reviewing and demonstrating the new barbed wire fence accessory from Woodland Scenics, and I'm starting right now. Hi, I'm Owen. In these videos, I'm continuing to build, expand, and improve my O-gauge Lionel Polar Express model railroad layout. Today, I'm taking a close look at the new barbed wire fence accessory from Woodland Scenics. Woodland Scenics offers this accessory in O, HO, and N scales. Here's the package containing my new O-scale barbed wire fence. It includes O-scale fence posts, barbed wire bracing posts, and a gate. Here's the complete contents list. I grew up on a farm in Wisconsin about 100 years ago. And building and maintaining fences was a never-ending part of life on the farm. In the winter, we cut oak trees in the woodlot to make fence posts. To slow down rot, we cut off the bark from the new post using a drawknife. I'll include a link to a photo of a drawknife in the comments. One of Abraham Lincoln's nicknames was the rail splitter. Well, I used barbed wire instead of split rails, but I did split a lot of oak logs to make two or more fence posts when the diameter was more than was needed for a single fence post. Building a fence line using this Woodland Scenics barbed wire fence kit will be way easier than my experience building real fences back on the farm. Instead of digging posts by hand with a clamshell post hole digger, I'll drill them using a 1/16-inch drill bit and an electric drill. One of the most difficult parts of building a new real fence was getting the wire tight enough so that it didn't sag and the cattle couldn't push through it. I'm going to be especially interested in how that will work with this O-scale fence. If you enjoy new product reviews and demonstrations, please subscribe to my channel. You'll be notified each time I upload a new product review. In addition, I also demonstrate construction tips and ideas, and I include frequent operating sessions so that you can see the trains in action on the layout. Also, please click the thumbs up down below and like this video and leave a comment to let me know what you think of the Woodland Scenics barbed wire fence kit. Now, let's build some fences. I'm going to be putting the kit in this area near the farm. The kit includes 42 inches or 106 centimeters of fence. The first step is to measure the circumference of the space I want to enclose. I've already done that, so I'm going to be able to skip over that in this video. Before I started working on the barbed wire fence, I put up this little rail fence across the back of the barn. That will prevent the cattle from getting out of the railroad track, which would be a fatal encounter. And the barbed wire fence will connect right here where this post is. It'll be another post side by side with that. That will begin the barbed wire fence, and then it'll go around behind the house and along the edge of the water feature. The idea is preventing the cattle from getting into the water feature and wandering their way across it and up onto the railroad track the other side. So that's my next challenge, is to get that fence put in place, and we'll be doing that next. You can see here that the fence construction is well underway. I've got a corner right there in the center of the picture. You can see the braces on either side of it, and I also have the fence line extended up along the back of the pond to the point where I ran out of posts and fence, and there I have that one braced as well. If we scroll back across to behind the barn, you can see I've still got fence posts to put in place. The way you do this is you drill a 1/16-inch hole where you want that post to go. And then once you have that 1/16-inch hole drilled, you can put a drop of super glue on it and then set that fence post down in there. There's a little pin on the bottom of each fence post that fits into that hole, that 1/16-inch hole. And here on the back of the barn, I'm joining it up with the end of the other fence that I put up, the rail fence. That will be posts set side by side, and I will be bracing that one as well. So that'll have a brace on it. There's the brace laying there, and you can see my tube of super glue there. So I'm going to go ahead and get that last part finished off, and we'll see how it looks once we're all done. And now my barbed wire fence is complete. I have it running around behind the barn where it starts off connected with the rail fence, and then around the tree and behind the cabin and along the shore of the pond. At this end, I've put a brace like I would use for a corner, although I'm not planning to put a corner there. I just wanted to make sure that the fence that I had put up stayed in place, and that helps to make sure it does that. You can see the bracing down at this corner, and there's a similar brace at the point where it intersects with the rail fence. Hard to see from this angle, but we'll get a different angle and we'll show that to you as well. One of the things I talked about earlier was the difficulty of getting the tension right on a barbed wire fence when you're building one in the real world. You need to stretch the wires and get them very taut in order for it to stay in place and be useful in keeping the cattle in. Now, on this barbed wire fence, I was wondering just exactly how that would work. And the answer is, as you can see here, it really doesn't. There's not the tension on this barbed wire fence that would be on one in the real world. However, I was able to tension up a little bit at this point by twisting the post at the corner. Before I put the braces up, before I glued it in place, I did a little bit of twisting on it, and that pulled a little bit tauter on the fence leading up to it. That's possibly something you could do with the other posts as well, but I'm a little hesitant to do that because I'm afraid they would not stay secure in place if there was too much tension on it. So that's the barbed wire fence. Let me get a different angle to show you how it intersects with the rail fence behind the barn. Well, there's the intersection of the rail fence and the barbed wire fence. You see a tiny little gap between the corner post for the rail fence and the corner post, or the end post, for the barbed wire fence. Now, what would we do to solve that problem in the real world? We would put another piece of wood in between there. We'd put a board in between them. And that's what I'm going to do. And that will solve that problem and prevent a little calf from squeaking out onto the railroad tracks. Well, now we've reached my favorite part of these videos. It's time to run the trains. We're going to get them going in just a moment.